Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron with the Catechism of the Catholic Church. We've been going through and doing some looks at this, like some teaching out of this. This is the second edition, 1997. I think it actually came out 1992 was the first one. It's also been enhanced by the addition of more than 100 pages that feature the following, and it goes into that. I've got another cool little one, this white raised gold letters and stuff, but interesting stuff. Now, a lot of people don't realize the Catholic Church is huge. About 1 billion people on earth, maybe 1.1 billion, are Catholic. And so let me just read to you some stuff. This is the celebration of Christian mystery. And so the sacrament of confirmation, this is Article 2 on page 325. I'll just show it to you so you'll kind of know I'm not making anything up. This was the first new compendium of Catholic doctrine regarding faith and morals in more than 400 years. And so I know my old pastor used to say we need a oneness catechism, and I agree, you know, it just kind of helps in teaching. I guess the Bible's our catechism. It says, okay, the sacrament of confirmation, baptism, the Eucharist, and the sacrament of confirmation, which is receiving the Holy Spirit, together constitute the sacraments of Christian initiation, whose unity must be safeguarded. It must be explained to the faithful that the reception of the sacrament of confirmation is necessary for the completion of baptismal grace. Now, what this says to me as an Acts 2:38 believer is that we realize Acts 2:38 was for the Jew first, then also to the Greek. You know, Romans 1:16, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It's power of God unto salvation of Christ. That's so important. Modern translations take that. Anyhow, that baptism in Jesus' name, reception of the Holy Ghost, refers back to John 3:5. They actually say that in here, but they're also baptizing either by immersion or pouring. They do it repeating Jesus' command in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Ghost, rather than obeying His command, Jesus' name. Look, read Luke 24. Jesus opened their understanding, the apostles' understanding, gave Peter the keys, opened their understanding. They didn't get it wrong on the day of Pentecost. They got it right. You have to say the name of Jesus and then receive the Holy Ghost. This is Christian initiation. It's fascinating that the Catholic Church, who in its embryonic stages kind of took over the See of Rome or the bishopric of Rome in 222 AD, study of church history, still say that water baptism and confirmation, which is reception of the Holy Ghost, are one event and are necessary for salvation. So I think in the Catholic Church, so many of their ceremonies, you see echoes of the reality of Scripture. I'm just going to be a New Testament Christian, and I would encourage every Catholic, I would encourage the Pope, I'd encourage everybody, repent and get baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. You shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. The promise is unto you, to your children, to all that are afar off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. So, you know, stacked within this, you find this, all this. Now, let's keep going here. Confirmation and the economy of salvation. The fullness of the Spirit was not to remain uniquely the Messiah's, but was be communicated to the whole Messianic people. On several occasions, Christ promised this outpouring of the Spirit, a promise which was fulfilled first on Easter Sunday, and then more strikingly at Pentecost. Filled with the Holy Spirit, the apostles began to proclaim the mighty works of God, and Peter declared the outpouring of the Spirit to be the sign of the Messianic age. Those who believed in the apostolic preaching and were baptized received the gift of the Holy Spirit in their turn. From that time on, the apostles, in fulfillment of Christ's will, imparted the newly baptized by the laying on of hands the gift of the Holy Spirit, which completes the grace of baptism. Whoa! And then it goes into Hebrews 6:2, where it does it in the plural, the doctrine of baptisms being foundational. So, may do some more teaching out of here. I just thought you might find that fascinating. So, God bless you. Just don't settle for the imitations. Get the real thing. And trust me, we love all Catholics. Hallelujah. We just want to give you the truth of salvation. God bless you. I'll talk with you later in Jesus' name.